I want to take a moment and get you excited about all the possibilities that exist with Arduino. There's so much you can do, it's absolutely amazing. Think about this, at its root, Arduino allows you to take what you might have up in your head, some ideas, and turn them into actual things. I mean, the programming code that you write, it has a physical element to it. It's kind of like bridging the gap between the virtual and the physical world. It's pretty awesome. So all different types of people with all different types of motivations are building really neat stuff, like robots, home automation, they're doing data logging, people are doing quadcopter control, they're building devices for the Internet of Things, they're making toys for their kids or their grandkids. Arduinos are being used in ham radio, and of course people are making fart machines with Arduino. It's really limitless. You can do just about anything you want. You know, and the people making this stuff, they come from all walks of life. Some people are younger, some people are older, some people have a ton of experience in electronics, and some don't. Some people come to it with a ton of programming experience, and some don't. The thing is, you don't have to be a genius to learn how to use Arduino. And you don't have to spend years studying books and going to college to be able to make neat things with your Arduino platform. Will programming and electronics experience help? Absolutely. But don't think that just because you're new to Arduino or you're not like a technical person or maybe you don't feel like you're good at math or any of that kind of stuff, don't be turned away. Give it a shot. I think you'll be amazed with what you can do with just a little bit of knowledge. Now, I'm not trying to say that Arduino doesn't have a learning curve, because it sure does. But hey, you're here. That's the idea of this course. I want to get you started on that learning curve. Now, you might find at times you get frustrated trying to learn Arduino. I know I sure do. You want to bang your head against the wall and you're like, man, why am I even doing this? So it's times like that that I want you to think, why did you decide to start learning this in the first place? I mean, do you have this cool project in mind, or do you have a project you want to be able to give to somebody or make, or do you just want the skills and ability to really create cool things with just your imagination? Those are the things you need to think back to when you're frustrated, when you're pulling out your hair, when you're about to smash your head into the wall. I can tell you this. It is easy to give up. It's easy to throw in the hat. But think about those things before you do that, because it really pays off if you stick through. It really pays off if you continue to learn, and you're going to be amazed with what you can accomplish. So, hey, let's go ahead and get started.